Welcome back, everyone, to another episode of Derch Nye. This time it is the Reaper and Splash Guy. Reaper has interesting interaction with some splash damage. In Borderlands, they made splash damage entirely too complicated, where there is grenade splash damage, there's rocket splash damage, and then there's the other splash damage that doesn't get any of those bonuses, but does get Reaper for some reason. And Maya loves that, because it does benefit her on certain guns. Although, if Reaper just affected all splash guns, and all splash guns also got grenade bonuses, it would have been even cooler. And hopefully in Borderlands 3, they simplify splash damage, but that is for another day. Today is talking about the guns that get splash damage on the pellet. So, I'm not going to go over and explain all the math right here, but I am going to show it on screen. Before I shoot these guns, and if you guys want to pause and kind of look at the equation, you can. But basically, Reaper can come separate from splash damage or post-splash damage. And if it boosts the gun damage and the splash damage, you obviously get more damage. Now, there's a short list of guns that do get this, where it gets the splash damage. And these are the ones I'm going to be showing you. And I'll show you the two separate equations on the screen so you can see it. So, the first one, probably the most interesting, is the SWORDSPLOSION. So, I have a single pellet one here, which makes it a lot easier for testing. So, it throws out a sword, which, don't kill myself here, which is different than the swords it shoots out. The main sword is different. The main sword gets it, the other ones do not. So, what it is, the main pellet has 100% splash damage. The secondary pellets have 70% splash damage. So if this gets Reaper, the main pellet will do 2,945,410, or you'll see on screen 2,945. The secondary pellets do 70% of the base damage, which is 736,356. Now, if it doesn't get Reaper on the main pellet, it would do 2,524,637. So I'm going to shoot them. This one's a little tricky, so I'm going to pause here. So right there you see 2,945 and a 736, which shows the main pellet has 100% splash and Reaper, where the secondary pellets do not get it. And this makes the SWORDSPLOSION pretty awesome on Maya, even though the secondary pellets don't get it. This also benefits from chain reaction, where those main swords bounce. They can re-put off those secondary ones. And any shotgun with the base damage of a million, when you can add it to three pellets with 100% splash, and you can put Reaper on that, and then you get unlisted pellets, it's a pretty badass shotgun for Maya. So, yeah, that's a pretty big damage difference. Even at this point where I should have shown this to start with, as you can see here, the only damage I have is Reaper. And no bar, no class mod, no relic, nothing else to affect the damage. So this is naked damage. And right there, it's a difference of 400,000 per sword. Or if you had three swords, 1.2 million. That's very significant. So you can see that getting Reaper on splash is important. It's not necessary, but it is important. Now, the other ones, the casual flak, or the Flakker, this one I do have more pellets just so you can see more land. So the damage on the Flakker is 777,313. And the Flakker has 100% splash damage in the form of the explosions it puts out. And you can see there, you got a whole lot of 1,088,000s. Whoops. Which, again, is a 40% increase from Reaper. So the Flakker gets Reaper on the splash damage. It means it does not get grenades, so sad day for Axton. The next is the Slowhand. So you see here, 698,000. Now this doesn't have a pellet, it's pure splash. So it's either it gets Reaper or it doesn't. And 977 means it does. And then the last one I have here is just a Hyperion splat gun, which is the exact same thing, the same base damage. So these do get it. because they are pure splash, no pellet. That's really easy to test. Now, just to show you, I have a TDR one here that is pure splash as well. 651,000. 651. This gets zero Reaper. So, sad day for non-Hyperion splat guns for Maya. Because splat guns don't get chain reaction. The non-Hyperion ones also do not get Reaper, making them extra shitty on her. So that is the shotguns. There is only one assault rifle, and this is the Sawbar. Now, the Sawbar is a bit interesting, because the main pellet will get Reaper. So if you do 236,000 times 1.4 for Reaper, times the, I mean, all bullets get Reaper, times the fire bonus of 1.75, you get that. Now, with the splash, I have to go way over here. This one's kind of tricky. Actually, I think over this shoulder is better. So there you go. 1,045,000. So how this works is, that's not a pellet hitting. That's pure splash. Now, the splits do have pellets, and if you can land those, you get that bonus added to them. But the fire explosions that come off those bullets are 200% splash damage. And then you get the Reaper on them, which is a 1.4, and then you get 1.75 for the fire on flesh, which gives you 1,045,000. Now, if it did not get Reaper, and it was just the 200 plus the fire, it would be 747,000 each one, which is 300,000 less per pellet, so 900,000 less damage if you land all three of them. Which, again, very significant. So this is one of the things that makes the Sawbar awesome with Maya. But also, besides that massive Reaper on that massive splash, it's unlisted, so it's good with a B and good with chain reaction. So that is the only assault rifle with splash damage that gets Reaper. The Hails do not, but the Hails still awesome on Maya. Next, we have a couple of pistols. So the little Evie here has a damage of 435,837. So if it gets Reaper, it will do 1,098,309. If it does not, it will be 958,841. And it's got it. It's still not that awesome on Maya, though. I'm trying to play around with like a little Eevee build, but I haven't got it quite right yet. So if I do ever get that quite right, I'll be posting that. Next is the Grog, and I actually forgot to free test this one, so I'm going to test this live with you guys. It's got 80% splash damage. I'm going to plug this into my calculator. And maybe I'll do a separate video of my calculator for you guys. You might enjoy that. So let's plug that in at 80%. So if this gets Reaper, it'll do 152,725. If it does not, it'll be 133,000. Let's see. 152. So the Grog gets Reaper, and it doesn't matter. But it does. The next one is also stupid, because it is the Chuliann. Now, this one's a little more complicated because it's got a separate bullet and splash. So again, bullets always have Reaper on them. The splash will not. So the bullet should do 244,000, which would be 174 times 1.4. The splash, then, if it has Reaper, will be 122,388. If it does not, it would be 87,420. So there you go. 244 from the pellet and 122 from the splash. Kind of like the Grog. As cool as it is to get splash on Reaper, this is one of the worst guns in the game because the penalty of self-slagging is terrible. So that kind of sucks with a small amount of guns that get splash on Reaper to have that as one of them. Next one is very cool, though. It is a Snider. So the Snider, if it gets Reaper, will be doing 1,710,555. If it does not, it'll do 1,547,645. 1,710. As you can see, the snipers get Reaper, which makes it a pretty awesome sniper for Maya. The next is the Pimpernel. This one might be a little tricky to get a clean hit on. I'm going to try to shoot him in the shoulder. But if this has splash, or Reaper on the splash, it will be 1,376,590. If it does not, it is 1,245,486. And there you got 1,376,000. Now that 917, I think the base damage of this is 655. Whoops, that's not what I wanted to do. So I'm going to quick get that for you, and it is a 50% splash. So that 917 was the bullet going vertical missing. That's the only one without splash. So when you shoot them, see the Pimpernel here, what happens is a bullet goes vertical, and that vertical bullet splits into five pellets. So the pellet that hits them is full damage with splash, 50%. The vertical pellet is full damage, no splash. And the five pellets that split off are bullets with splash. So this one is a really big deal. I'm going to try to shoot the ground here with him. 458. It's hard to land those secondary ones and actually hit him. And that's, I'm just hitting this. Oh, there's one hit. You get that 1,376,000. The other one at 458. So that is just a splash hit with Reaper. I will put that math up on the screen. Now that I had to double check it. And that is the Pimpernel, the most confusing gun in the game that I love, other than the Twister. The last one here is the Cobra. So the Cobra has the base damage of 1,088,887. And it has an 80% splash damage. So if this has got Reaper on the splash, it'll be 2,743,995. If it does not, it will be 2,395,551. And there you go. 2743. So this one also has it. So that is all the guns that get Reaper on splash in the entire game. So you have the Cobra, the Pimpernel, and the Sniders. The Volcano and Storm do not. You got the little Evie, the nasty Sawbar, the Chuliann, the Grog, the Flakker, the Slowhand, the SWORDSPLOSION, Hyperion splatguns, and not that one. So that's your list, and that's kind of how you test for it, too. Of course, you'll see the math. And if you guys are interested, let me know. I could do a quick video showing you my calculator as well, because you might like that. It's probably the most advanced damage and DPS calculator out there for Borderlands. It's a little bit raw, but it's pretty awesome. So anyways, once again, thanks for watching. I hope you guys appreciate it, and I hope you learned something here. Maybe I can do one of these for accident with grenade damage bonuses as well, if you guys would enjoy that. That's it for now. I would do the big long outro, but I'm about to get into a massive coughing fit, so I will just see you guys later. Bye.